Everybody, welcome to this week's Dennis Kirk Tech Tip. This week, I'm going to talk to you about replacing the coolant in your motorcycle's radiator and cooling system. The stuff that comes in your bike is certainly good and it works, but why take the risk of overheating? We've had great luck with engine ice radiator coolant, which is biodegradable and non-toxic. Back in the day, the guy that founded engine ice, Dave Kimmy, was at a trade show. And he was telling me about how it's non-toxic and everything. You could drink it. Like, oh, let me see you take a sip. And sure enough, he took a little swig of it for me to prove to me that it was completely safe. Been a big fan of engine ice ever since. It actually does help our test bikes run cooler, especially during the summer and shootout season when it's really hot out here in Southern California. We obviously don't have to worry about things freezing here in the winter like some people in the Midwest do, but you're not riding your dirt bikes in anyway. So today we're going to replace the stock coolant with this great blue engine ice stuff. For this job, we will need a 10 millimeter socket, a large Phillips, a rag obviously for cleanup, brand new coolant. In this instance, we are using engine ice performance coolant, which is biodegradable. And also a bottle of tap water or glass or whatnot. And you'll also need a container to drain the old existing coolant into. Okay, so first step is to remove the radiator cap. So Kawasaki's actually have a bleeder cap on the other side, on the other radiator. Remove that as well. That's where the Phillips comes in handy. This allows you to drain and refill the radiators without a vacuum walk. Also, you want to remove the caps and the bleeders before you remove the drain bolt because that allows the fluid to come out. And that also reduces the pressure because if you don't remove the bleeder screw from the other side, when you first take the bolt out, the radiator fluid will shoot out high pressure. Because we've done both, should just trickle out nice and easy. So as it's draining, you want to keep an eye on the pressure of the stream and move the tub accordingly. Okay, so this step is not completely required unless you're replacing the coolant with a type that is non-compatible with others. There are some, I believe Redline coolant is like that, but just to make sure we have all engine ice in there, I'm gonna pour a bottle of water to flush the system. Though it seems everything's out, you do want to tilt the bike a little. A few more ounces will come out. Get all the old stuff out so we can put all the good new stuff in. Obviously the next step is to replace the drain bolt. Always start the thread by hand so you don't cross thread with the tool. Snug it up, fill up the bike with the good stuff, engine ice high performance coolant. Some people would use a funnel. My dad always said, my eyes and ears and hands are the funnel. So as we're filling it up, you could hear air leaving the bleed valve on the other radiator. As you can see, some fluid has come out the bleeder, indicating that this side radiator is full. So replace the plug and start the threads by hand so you don't cross thread. So just inspect your cap, make sure it's not damaged or bent, and replace it. Make sure you get it turned past the little safety. You're good to go. Maybe take a rag, wipe down the rest of the bike. Happy trails.